Hi, this is Mike Elliott, and you're watching a CEO Live executive interview. In this episode, we'll be talking to Mr. Thomas Paulson. He's the Chief Financial Officer at NovaBay Pharmaceuticals, a clinical stage biotechnology company focused on the topical anti-infective market. NovaBay Pharmaceuticals is a publicly traded company listed on the New York Stock Exchange market under ticker symbol NBY. Good afternoon, Tom. Thanks for joining us.
Good to be with you, Mike. Thanks for having me.
One of NovaBay's taglines is, quote unquote, going beyond antibiotics. How are you accomplishing this and why is it so important?
Yes, good question, Mike. Well, NovaBay was founded around the concept of antibiotics and can we develop a new family of antibiotics that would address the growing global crisis of antibiotic resistance. Your listeners may not be aware of this, but there's 150 antibiotics that are used in the market today, all of which are developing some level of resistance. In effect, the bugs are winning the war, if you will, by developing new mutations and evolving around the effectiveness of given the antibiotics we have in the market today. So NovaBay was founded around the concept, is there a new approach we could take, a new design in antibiotic drug development that could get around this resistance problem? And that led to a search to mechanisms of action that perhaps would work. And that led to the white blood cell, which defends us humans day in and day out, estimated a billion times a day, our body will be challenged with some invading microbe, and your white blood cells will faithfully attack and destroy these microbes. So what happens in that event that we could perhaps learn from and develop a new drug from? Well, as it turns out, the chemistry that your white blood cells use is been known for quite some time. There are molecules such as hypochlorous acid, N-chlorotoluene, and so on, that effectively kill. And one would think, gee, why hasn't a drug company discovered this chemistry and used it in a commercial enterprise? It makes sense. Well, the problem is these molecules are rather short-lived. And by the time you'd manufacture, ship them to your warehouse, send them to Duane Reade or Walgreens or CVS, they lose their potency. So NovaBay's mission was to see, is there a way we could stabilize these molecules and impart longevity to them? And in fact, that's what was accomplished here at NovaBay. We effectively were able to take these molecules while keeping their killing capacity for bacteria, virus, and fungi, all three, maintain their killing capacity, which is essentially chlorine-based, and stabilize the molecule so now you could have 2 and 3 year shelf life. So for the first time, you could have white blood cells in a bottle, if you will, and in fact, harness the killing capacity of the white blood cell for topical infections. So that's the core essence of NovaBay. And our lead molecule, oriclosine, is now in three different clinical trials, three advanced clinical trials to treat skin infections, eye infections, and for urinary catheter problems. So this is a big year for NovaBay, where we're for the first time going to have all this advanced clinical data coming in a relatively short period of time over the next 6 to 9 months.
And that kind of actually segues into my next question, which brings up a recent press release earlier this month. NovaBay CEO Dr. Ron Najafi explained that 2013 is an important year for NovaBay due to some data coming out in the second half of this year from some of your current phase two clinical studies. So could you give us a little insight into what products these clinical studies are for and what the next phase is after the data comes out?
Yes, gladly. Well, the three programs that are, like say, in phase two. One is for a problem that's a serious concern of people that are chronically catheterized, people that have are paraplegics, quadriplegics, perhaps people that have had strokes or MS, and they need to be permanently catheterized. And they often suffer from a problem of urinary catheter blockage and incrustation, which causes a higher morbidity and mortality, because this can lead to backup of the catheter into the bladder and potentially into the kidneys, can cause sepsis and large-scale infections. So what we're doing is, in effect, irrigating the urinary catheter so that these blockages don't occur. Now, one might say, well, can't you just flush these frequently? Well, in fact, that's what is the current course of care, is a flushing with saline or citric acid 2 to 3 times per day, which is a rather high level of compliance to shoot for. So there is relatively low compliance on doing that. And in effect, it doesn't treat the core problem of this blockage, which is the bugs that cause this incrustation to form. What Novabay is doing with oriclosine in an irrigating solution, what our trial was hopefully show, is with 1 or 2 treatments per week, rather than 3 times per day, keep these catheters clear and patent. And thereby you don't form the biofilm that's the original cause, or the solid incrustation that forms later, and thereby keep the catheters clean and keep the patients healthy, and a much big improvement in their care. So that data is expected in the second half of this year. Second, we're working with our partner Galderma out of France, who is really the largest pharmaceutical company in the world focused on dermatology. It's a private company joint venture between L'Oreal and Nestle, and they're world leaders in treating dermatological conditions. So we're working with them to treat the skin infection of impetigo, highly contagious, mostly affecting children. And the market data shows that roughly 20 million prescriptions are written per year to treat impetigo. Now, again, we have a new approach here using oriclosine, which will effectively kill the bugs that are responsible for the infection, primarily Staph aureus, without giving rise to resistance. There are products on the market today, but they do give rise to resistance. In some cases, up to 40% of patients treated have been demonstrated resistance. So the market we've seen and have demonstrated with our own market research shows that physicians, dermatologists, pediatricians are looking for a new drug that won't give rise to resistance. So we estimate the market, and Galderma does, roughly $600 million around the world for this. And in fact, we look at it as a gateway indication. Once we have this drug approved, the opportunity to look for other infections other than impetigo is very large and will probably be pursued. Thirdly, there's our drug for viral conjunctivitis. Now, this is an unmet medical need. I'm sure your audience has heard of pink eye, very common skin infection. Mm-hmm. Now, that can be caused by either bacteria or viruses. And while there are plenty of antibiotics on the market to treat the bacterial form of conjunctivitis, there is no product approved anywhere on the planet for the viral form, which can be sight-threatening. So this market, we estimate roughly to be millions of patients in the U.S., approximately 3 million we're estimating, with a total value of $700 million to $1 billion globally, has no market to treat today. And we're seeing in oriclosine in our phase 2A study, we saw effectiveness versus vehicle are quite impressive, particularly in clearing the blurred caused by this indication. So that trial is a global trial. It's being conducted in the U.S., in India, and Brazil. And there too, we hope to have results from that trial by the end of the year. So again, we have, we're treating urinary catheter blockage. That'll be early part of second half. And then there's impetigo with Galderma running that trial globally. That'll be approximately early fourth quarter. And then for conjunctivitis, that data will be towards the end of this year. So rarely, I think, you'll see a biotech company with this much advanced clinical data coming out in such a short period of time, roughly the next 6 to 9 months. So this is really NovaBay's year for significant clinical evidence of the efficacy of oriclosine.
That is very significant, and we definitely would like to follow up with you later this year to see how all that pans out. Final question, Tom. I'd like to discuss your recent press release announcing NovaBay support for the legislation to attack antibiotic resistance. Mm-hmm. Seems to be on topic. Right. The STAR Act. Could you tell us just basically why you think this legislation is important and why NovaBay is supporting it?
Yeah. No, it's very, very good. Very important legislation. And in fact, this is really the genesis in large part to why we have an antibiotic resistance problem. The act is really to bore in and study and address the causes of this antibiotic resistance problem. That's a global issue. For instance, in our livestock industry, to protect chickens, if you will, or cattle that are breeding and in the livestock industry, literally tons of antibiotics are used and mixed with feed to prevent large-scale epidemic infections among feedstock. And because you've got, if you have one animal become infected and ill, it could decimate the whole stock that you're trying to cultivate for use to feed the produce market. So that's why it's given prophylactically as part of feed to animals. Now, of course, from there, as animals consume it and excrete it, it goes into our groundwater, it goes into our streams, rivers, and it's the stories are sort of horrific, where if any of your viewers are in near any body of water, there's no doubt that antibiotics are in that water. They're in the sediment in any lake, river, stream, or so on. Here, we're in the San Francisco Bay Area. The San Francisco Bay is confirmed to have 15 to 20 different antibiotics that are you can find in the sediment in the San Francisco Bay. And you can find the Lake of the Ozarks, in fact, these pristine lakes that are in the middle of nowhere, if you will, have found 20 different antibiotics there, because you find they're relatively near chicken farms that are used by the poultry industry, and that eventually winds up in the groundwater. So the legislation is there to address this need to look for different alternatives to again prevent infections and protect livestock. However, the current approach isn't working. So we certainly support this. Nova Bay is doing its part. Obviously, we're not the answer to all the problems we have with antibiotic resistance, but it is an approach where we can address significant markets in some way to start to address this problem of killing, like, effectively bacteria, viruses, and fungi without giving rise to resistance. And in fact, drug companies, as you know, have stopped developing antibiotics. The problem being often that a company will spend literally hundreds of millions of dollars to develop an antibiotic. And at the end of the day, they'll wind up with a label claim approved by the FDA that gives them very limited usage, because they know it's only a matter of time before this drug will to become, and bugs will develop resistance to it. So the label claim will often say, in effect, only use this drug after everything else doesn't work. So ultimately, spending these literally hundreds of millions of dollars will result in a very minor market share. So that's suppressed development of new antibiotics. They've gone down over the years. And why Nova Bay's products are being relatively well received by the FDA, because they know this is the type of drug they want in the market. In effect, we are going beyond antibiotics with this new approach we have.
Tom, I want to thank you. That's all the questions I had for today. Anything else you wanted to add? Any closing comments before we end?
No. That we pretty much covered it, Mike. I just say, if your listeners have the initiative, I know certainly this affects everybody. We all get infections. We all need good antibiotics, and corresponding with their congressperson would certainly have an effect on this. The more Congress is aware and their constituents are concerned about this matter and communicate that, the more likely are to put good legislation in effect as soon as possible.
Tom, it's been a pleasure.
Okay. Thanks so much, Mike. Enjoyed it. Thank you very much.
We've been talking to Mr. Thomas Paulson. He's the Chief Financial Officer at Nova Bay Pharmaceuticals. They're a clinical stage biotechnology company focused on the topical anti-infective market. Nova Bay Pharmaceuticals is a publicly traded company. It's listed on the New York Stock Exchange market under ticker symbol NBY, and you can find out more about them by visiting their website at www.novabay.com. Thank you.